Good evening. Anthony Albanese has called for optimism and hope, not fear and division, as he laid out his vision for Australia. Launching Labor's campaign, the opposition leader vowing his government will cut the cost of housing, medicine and childcare, all while boosting wages.
Labor always lionises its leaders, both past and present. The True Believers moved their campaign launch to Perth for the first time.
In the great state of Western Australia.
Where three seats might turn this election as Anthony Albanese stepped back onto centre stage, making a presidential pitch.
My fellow Australians.
To be Prime Minister.
That's what this election is all about. A better future for Australia.
Built on the firm foundation of demonising the incumbent.
People know Scott Morrison goes missing when the going gets tough.
While building a modest platform based on renewal, not revolution.
Labor has real lasting plans for cheaper electricity, cheaper childcare, cheaper mortgages, cheaper medicines and Medicare, and for better pay.
Today, the opposition leader pledged to get more people into their own homes.
I want to build a better future and I want to help more Australians own a stake in it.
10,000 spots would be up for grabs for individuals earning up to $90,000 and couples on $120,000. The government would cover 30% of an existing home or 40% of a new home. Once the property was bought, the owners could start buying more of it off the government. Labor says it will cost $329 million over the next 4 years, but could also make the government money when the homes are sold.
Because that's what good government should do.
On the other side of the country in Sydney, Scott Morrison was holding his own rally and confronting his own demons.
Unemployment is at... That's it. Did you get that, Anthony?
As in this most personal of campaigns, he took aim at his rival.
This is no time for weakness. Elections are a choice. They are a choice, and there is a choice between strength and weakness.
Back in WA, Labor was outbidding the government by $2.50 on bringing down the cost of medicines listed on the pharmaceutical benefit scheme.
This means the maximum price for PBS medicines will be just $30.
Anthony Albanese now has 20 days to convince Australians that he and his party are fit to lead the nation in the uncertain times ahead. And right now, this race is a long way from won. With the leader back in the game, new polling for the Sydney Morning Herald and Age Resolve Political Monitor reveals a week in COVID isolation doesn't seem to have hurt Anthony Albanese, who has narrowed the gap with Scott Morrison as preferred Prime Minister by 2 points. Voters, though, remain deeply divided. Those who have made up their minds are split three ways. One third planning to vote for the coalition, one third Labor, and one third for minor parties or independents. Today, the choice straddled both sides of this divided nation.
You cannot run to be Prime Minister of this country and says, I'll make it up when I get there.
Vote Labor so together we can build a better future, a better future for all Australians. Thank you very much.
The party faithful was sold on the message. Now he must win the rest of the nation.
OK, let's go live to Perth and Nine's political editor, Chris Yuleman. Chris, why did the Labor leader choose WA for today's campaign launch?
Because this is where the election might be won and lost, Pete, which is unusual because this has traditionally been a Liberal Party stronghold. The party holds 10 of the 15 seats here. But at the last state poll, there was almost an extinction-level event for the Liberals. They now only hold 2 seats in that state legislature. So if even a little bit of that love rubs off on Anthony Albanese, he's hoping to pick up 3 seats here. So it could be a long election night and decided in the West for the first time in a long time, Pete.
All right, Chris, thank you.